we're trying to do here is take the apparent chaos of the language and find some kind of pattern or structure that will help us to make sense of it. So far, we've looked at the basic structure of transitive verbs, that is, verbs that can take an object, in the third person form of the simple aspect of the present tense. So we can say things like, the girl asks a question. We can say it with emphasis. The girl does ask a question. And in negative form, the girl doesn't ask a question. And we can ask ourselves, does the girl ask a question? We can do the same thing in the plural, so we can make sentences like, do the girls ask questions? If you're happy with all of that, let's carry on.
Mm-hmm.
To get the best out of this structure, we need to add a few more ingredients to the pot. Shazam! Quantifiers. Shazam! Adjectives. Shazam! The first person of the verb. Shazam! The second person of the verb. And pronouns. And proper nouns. Uncountable nouns. Adverbs. Intransitive verbs. That'll give us a few more options. Let's take a look at those. Let's take a simple sentence like, cats like fish. We've seen how we can use a determiner with a noun. We can say, the cats, for example. Well, we can also use quantifiers, like all, or some, or a lot of, or a few. They're not the same as numbers, which tell us exactly how many, but they give us an idea of quantity. We can also use adjectives to describe the noun. The cats could be big, or small, or domestic, or wild. And we can combine quantifiers and adjectives to say things like all big cats or some small cats. That would be if we were talking about cats in general. But if there was a group of cats and some of them were big while others were small, we could add a determiner and say things like all the big cats or some of the small cats. Yes, I know. In some cases we need of, and in others we don't. Well, that's the kind of thing you're going to have to check separately. I'll recommend one or two books and websites afterwards.
All right.
Now let's look at different kinds of subjects and objects. We've been looking at what are called common nouns, like cat or book or something like that. But we can also use pronouns, I and we, that is the first person of the verb, singular and plural, you, the second person, the same in singular and plural, and they and he, she and it, which are the third person. And when they're in object's position, I becomes me, we becomes us, you stays the same, he changes to him, she changes to her, it stays the same, and they becomes them. So we can say things like, I like them, or you like us, or we like her, or they like you. But if we use he or she or it as subjects, we need to add s to the verb. So it would be he likes her, she likes him, and so on. There are two more kinds of nouns I'd like to mention at this stage. One is proper nouns, that is, names of people and places like Anna or Zane or Japan or the Eiffel Tower. These have a capital letter at the beginning, and we don't use determiners with most of them, although there are a few like the Eiffel Tower or the United Kingdom that take the.
I suppose we'll have to study that by ourselves as well.
Yes, I'm afraid so.
I know. You'll recommend some good books and websites.
That's right. There's one other thing we need to know about nouns at this stage, and that is that English makes a difference between things that can be counted and things that can't. Water, for example, isn't countable in the same way that cats are, or tables and chairs and cups. This is a complicated topic because the same thing can often be both countable and uncountable depending on the situation. We'll come back to this later on, but for now, let's just notice that when a noun is uncountable, it doesn't have a plural. We can talk about cats and more cats using the plural, but usually we'll talk about water and more water in the singular. Looking at the verb, just as we can describe nouns using adjectives to say a good book or a small cat, so we can give more information about verbs using adverbs. Some adverbs go in front of the verb, like the boy often reads a book. Others go in a different position. Cats like fish very much.
But how do we know which ones go where?
I think we'll just have to wait until he explains it.
I hope he explains it later on. I'm a bit confused.
Maybe we can find a book or a website that explains it.
That's a good idea.
So far, I've been talking about transitive verbs which take an object.
The boy reads the book, the cat climbs the tree, and so on.
But many verbs in English are intransitive. For example, if we sleep, we don't sleep something. We just sleep. But we can talk about how we sleep, or where we sleep, and things like that. That's most of the basic information you need in order to use the present simple. It's not everything. And anyway, transformational grammar by itself isn't enough. You'll need to back up what I've told you with information from standard grammar books and websites. Here are one or two I recommend. These are useful books, full of good, clear information about how to use the language. And as for websites, well, there are so many, I can't count them. Here are a few.